Top five answers on the board. Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
Sporting event.
Sporting event.
Strip club.
Strip club.
We're gonna play.
All right, great. Hey, Eva, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say a bar.
At the bar.
Good answer.
Hello, Bria.
Hey.
Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
Maybe picking up some drugs, Steve.
Good answer.
I'm picking up some drugs. Tess, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
His side chick's house.
Good answer. Good answer.
Over the side chick's house. Tony, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
I'm gonna say casino.
At the casino. Yeah. One answer left. We can clear the board, Kevin. Name a place a man has a good time till his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say over at his friend's house.
Over at his friend's house. That was a good answer. Two strikes. Got to be careful now, Eva. David's family could steal, or you can clear the board. Name a place a man has a good time till his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say at work.
Okay.
At work. All right, family. Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
At a bachelor party.
At the bachelor party. Top four answers on the board. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties. Michelle.
Silk.
Silk. You better come on, Michelle. Michelle, congratulations. That's how you play relax. Chris, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
We'll go with cotton, Steve.
Cotton. Man, I love you, Chris. Chris, you my man, boy. Oh, man. Got your dad down there?
Father-in-law.
He done a hell of a job, don't he?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Now, let me ask you a question here. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Lace, Steve.
Come on, boy. Lace! Crystal?
Crystal.
Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Polyester.
I want to be clear. I don't know the rest of these answers. But cotton and polyester? Christian, If you give me this answer, we're still alive. We've got two strikes, though. We gotta be careful. The other family can steal and win the game. Christian, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Spandex.
Spandex! Family, I got two answers. You give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the smoke family is going to win the game. I need an answer. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
We're gonna go with latex.
Great answer.
This is for the win. Latex! Number four, I don't know.
Candy tried.
Oh my God.
Three. Yay. Well, let's go meet them, everybody. It's the Dowdy family. Yay. Hold on one second.
Okay. Okay,
I see.
Ooh. Come on, my brother.
What's up, boy? Good. T.
Get the food, boy. Come here for you, man. Get a word, man.
What's up? Look at the deal. Yeah. I've been friends with that dude for 61 years. Oh, wow. He surprised me. Grew up next door to me. Wow. Been in Cleveland 61 years. Wow. Should've told me you was coming, man. I feel like crying seeing your punk ass. Top eight answers on the board, ladies. We asked 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed. Angela.
A police officer.
A police officer.
Oh.
Cindy.
A dancer.
A dancer. We ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A yoga instructor.
Yoga instructor. Hey, Mike, 100 women, an occupation a man has makes him good in bed.
Bodybuilder.
Yeah.
A bodybuilder. Jen, we ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
No explanation with this one.
No, you just did
it. Okay, well then, he's got a pole, he's got a hose, a fireman!
He got a pole, he got a hose, fireman! Hey, Lori, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, so I think maybe because he knows about lady parts, a gynecologist?
Gynecologist. Cindy, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Construction worker.
A construction worker. Chuck, only one strike. You'll put a stop to that. Name an occupation that a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, Steve, what about a plumber?
This boy right here. This boy right here is just for my entertainment. I love you, dude.
Yes.
Plumber! I ain't mad at you. Mike, two strikes. The other family can steal. Give me an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A farmer.
Y'all messing with me now. You know, good with them hoes, you know what I'm saying?
That's where the saying came from, farmers are good in bed.
Farmer!
Come on!
Talk to 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
I'm gonna go with musician.
A musician, yeah. Number seven. Six. All right now, guys, top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Joseph. Shopping.
Yeah, she is. Yeah. Shopping. L'Oreal, we asked 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
I would be doing the nasty with Steve.
I don't give a damn if that ain't up there. Best answer I've ever heard, 13 years, do the nasty with Steve Harvey. Gemma? Talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Tuning in, watching Family Feud.
Tuning in. Tuning in, watching Family Feud. Miss Loria, talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
At the spa.
At the spa. That's a good answer. Now, Sterling, you got to be careful. We got two strikes. The Sonya family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Traveling.
Traveling.
Yes.
Traveling. Joseph, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Other family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Planning dinner.
You need to be at the house cooking me some damn dinner. We asked 100 women, you and Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Count my money.
Counting my Woo! Money. Send that to the house. Fine.
Divorcing him.
Nah. Number three.
Sleeping.
Let's go meet the Wallace family. Hello, Edith.
Hello, Steve.
How are you, darling?
I am very well, thank
good,
you.
Good, good, good. Well, Edith, introduce everybody.
Well, Steve, I have my handsome veteran Army son, Jonathan.
Army strong.
Yeah.
My beautiful war veteran, Air Force daughter, Jeannie. My gorgeous and entrepreneurial niece, Candy. And down there, Steve, that's just Judy. She's my sister and your biggest fan. Hey, Steve!
Cheryl Underwood.
Hey,
I looked, as soon as I looked okay. down there, I fell in love with you. I said, I'll be damned. That's my girl, Cheryl. Well, listen, I'm going to get to know y'all as the day goes along. enjoy yourself. Who came to win $20,000? Let's go. Give me Eric, give me Edie. All right, guys, we got top eight answers on the board. Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him. Edith.
Photos.
Photos.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. All right, Jonathan. Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Food.
Okay.
Food. Miss Janine, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Sex life.
His sex life.
Yes.
Candy, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Clothes.
His clothes! Hey, Cheryl.
Oh, my goodness, Steve. You
that
are
is
funny,
my girl
Steve.
Right here, man. I knew, I love, when I turned the corner, I said, hey, welcome to the show. I said, I love her. I look right over there. Come on, Judy, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him. We only got one strike. Edith, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
If they lived in the same house, she would leave him.
If they lived in the same house.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hey, Jonathan, something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Water, a water bottle, drink.
What?
Good water answer. Bottle.
A stained glass.
Good answer, good answer.
Water, you can't have. Stop giving her water. All right, Jeannie, we got two strikes. Got to be careful. Jorgensen family can steal. Name something if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Their money.
Their money. That was a good answer. Name something if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Steve, we're gonna say a toothbrush.
Toothbrush! Number eight.
More than three times.
Six. Top seven answers on the board. Name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Beyonce.
You better know it. Greatest living performer today, Beyonce knows.
Cardi B.
Cardi B.
We're playing, Steve.
Beyonce's number four. Wow. It's gonna be interesting. Michael, name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Diana Ross.
Diana Ross. She does, though. Michelle. Name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
J-Lo.
J-Lo! Name a female singer to bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey. Come on now, come on. Let's think this out, man. Let's get some points on this board. We got two strikes, Dirt Family can steal. Mia look pretty confident. Female singer, bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande. Name a female singer who can bring the house down when she performs live.
We're gonna go with Shakira. Woo! Yeah.
Woo! Shakira. Number seven. That's a true statement. Six.
Reba McEntire.
Five.
Cher.
Three.
Carrie Underwood.
Number one.
I just love
her. Lady Gaga.
Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Set.
Can I change it?
I like the way Lori said, set. Set.
Cut.
Cut.
Play, Steve.
Oh, I got you. All right, Danielle, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Action.
Action. Cindy, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
I'm going to say lights.
Lights. Alex, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Take one.
Take one. Michael, we got two strikes. If it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other team can steal and they get to play sudden death.
How about break?
Break!
Good answer. Yeah. Good answer.
I got two answers on the board, family. Here's the situation for you. If you give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family gets to play sudden death. Woo. But if it's not there, Morrison family, flat out, they win the game.
Yeah.
So we need this one. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Quiet.
Good answer.
Quiet. Quiet on the set. Number four.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Dowdy Girls won the game. And now it's time to play.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
My mother-in-law.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Temperature.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
The seatbelt.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
5 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coca-Cola.
Name someone in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said mother-in-law. Survey said. Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank. You said temperature. Survey said. Name a safety device on a roller coaster. You said seatbelt. Survey said. What time does a gym rat work out in the morning? You said 5 a.m. Survey said. Name a brand of cola. You said Coca-Cola. Survey said.
Hey, Steve.
You nervous?
A little bit, just but I'm be okay.
I don't know how to tell you this.
Break it to him fast. Break it to him fast.
You don't like all this waiting
around?
No,
just don't even, just cut out.
You want to hear about it?
Let me hear.
You need 2 points.
Oh,
Let me be a little bit clearer.
I'm sorry.
You need 2 damn points.
Okay. Yes. Okay. I forgot. What else I was doing?
2.
Okay.
You ready?
Ready.
Let's put that 198 points up on the board, all the answers, please. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Amy, name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
Husband.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Blood pressure.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
Seatbelt.
Try again.
Safety harness.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
Oh, 5 a.m.
Try again.
6 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coke.
Try Pepsi. Again. I sure hope you get this 2 points. You need 2 points, $20,000. Somebody in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said... Survey said... Number one answer. All of them. Whatever she said, that was the number one answer. Answers on the board. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows. Carrie.
He lies.
Leo. Sir. Name something a cheating husband does the moment he realizes his wife knows.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Good answer.
Oh. Stop. Hey, man, we got one strike. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He cries.
Yeah. He cries. Tell me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He buys her something.
Come on. He buys her something. Big Nate, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Moves out.
I just caught you cheating. Moves out. Yeah. Carrie, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Maybe apologize.
Apologize. Going pretty good. Leo, wow. My man. Here we go. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He tells the truth about it.
Yeah.
What's up there? You gotta just tell the truth sometimes, you know? And it sets you free.
What's up there?
The truth will set you free.
He don't cheat, so he gotta tell the truth.
Don't even work in court, partner. Listen to me. There's a couple things you're gonna need to understand about cheating. Once you tell the lie, you must ride the lie all the way out. Tells truth about it. All right, we got two strikes. Salvo, we got to be careful. The Russell family can steal. Okay. Give me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
A divorce.
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 Divorce. Okay, family. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He goes and gets drunk.
He goes and gets drunk. Number seven. Four.
A knife.
A knife. All right, we're going to play.
Good job, good job.
Brian, name something a husband sees on his wife's shopping list and makes him fear she's planning a murder.
I'm going to say rat poison.
Rat poison.
Hey, get it? Yeah.
Brian, something a husband sees on that wife's shopping list make him think she's planning a murder.
How about some rope?
Rope?
Time up.
Michelle, something her husband sees on the wife's shopping list make him think she's planning a murder.
Duct tape.
Duct tape. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
There you go.
Boy, y'all that little smart little family just rolling here. All right, all right. That little serial killer family. Lisa, name something her husband sees on his wife's shopping list makes him fear she's planning a murder.
Well, this object can be used in the garden, but this shovel is gonna dig his hole.
Oh. Yeah. Good answer.
Dig his grave.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Sorry, Lucky.
Good answer.
I didn't know where she was going with this story. Use it in the garden. But this item. Shovel! Stephanie, name something her husband sees on the wife's shopping list make him think she's planning a murder.
How about an axe?
Ooh.
An axe. Yeah. Brian, something her husband sees on wife's shopping list make him think she's planning a murder.
An ice cooler. A gigantic refrigerator.
Good answer, good answer.
An ice cooler? I want to ask you so bad what you do with that ice cooler, but I can't allow you to elaborate. You might say another answer, so I'm going to have to just go with the ice cooler. Folks, I probably never said this on the show, but just based on the answers that you guys have given so far, y'all done killed some people, ain't you?
No comment.
Okay. I'm telling you what I know now. This boy right here done went and got an ice cooler. How in the hell this man done thought of ice cooler? Something has happened at they house. Two strikes, Brian. You gotta be careful. Maul family can steal. All right. Give me something my husband sees on wife shopping list, make him fear she's planning a murder.
It's that gun.
Gun.
Yeah.
A gun! One answer left. Michelle, you can clear the board and prove it once and for all that you folks know what you're doing. Two strikes. Be careful. My whole family can steal. Name something my husband sees on the wife's shopping list and makes him fear she's planning a murder.
Garbage bags.
Oh. Hey, good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Look at me. 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 Folks, this is starting not to be funny. Ice cooler, garbage bag. You got a gun, nice damn duct tape. They ain't left nothing off. This pro stuff here. Garbage bags. I don't care if it's up there or not. Something done happened at their house. It's a garbage bag! Name something a husband sees on his wife's shopping list and makes him fear she's planning a murder.
Steve, we're gonna go with gloves.
Yeah!
Wow. Yeah. Gloves! That's a good answer. You can give a good answer and not be up there. All of them was pretty good answers. Number six.
Hammer!
Damn. I can deal with the gun, but you ain't gonna sit here and just beat me to death. J.E., name something people complain is clingy.
I always have a kid hanging from my legs because I have five children, so your children, your kids.
Yeah, that's a great answer. That's good. Ooh, that's good. Surprise. Boy, I love this boy right here.
I'm waiting, Steve.
No, let me cry. I love this boy right here. You know, everybody in here in on this one. Woo, J.E., you standing there waiting on it. Is it up there? Folks, is it up there?
Yeah!
Steve, hurry up, man!
Steve, look at the board.
Oh. All right, J.E., name something that people complain is clingy.
Your furniture.
Your furniture.
Yeah, like leather, if you sit on it.
Yeah.
Furniture!
We go. Name something a woman does for her baby that she... Yes.
Changes his diaper.
Changes his diaper. Name something a woman does for her baby that she also does for her hubby. So your big nasty man just laying his little nasty self up there, just boo-booing on his big old funky tail, huh? Change his diaper! Okay, folks, here we go. Top seven answers are on the board. Name something of his wife's that a man might secretly use.
Razor.
Razor! One answer, Rick.
Deodorant.
Deodorant. Pass or play, Rick.
They're gonna play.
They're gonna play, Andy. Hey, Stephanie.
Hi, how are you?
How you doing? What do you do?
I am actually an Air Force intelligence officer.
You?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
I know.
Hey, name something of his wife that a man might secretly use.
I would say lotion.
The lotion. Miss Helen, how you doing?
I am great.
Like that haircut.
Oh, thank you.
Looks rather jazzy on you.
Yeah, and as stiff as a board.
Well, hey, you know, hairspray, that's what it's for. That's good. I ain't mad at you. Miss Helen, name something of his wife that a man might secretly use.
Her hair coloring.
Oh, good answer.
Her hair coloring.
Her oh, hair color.
Yes.
Okay. The hair color. Good answer. Judy, how you doing?
Very good. How are you?
What do you do, ma'am?
I'm a registered nurse and a mother of an adult son, Thomas, a 165-pound dog, and a 20-pound cat.
Well, we know you weigh everything. Judy, name something of his wife that a man might secretly use.
The bathrobe.
The bathrobe?
Yes! Mm.
Wow, we got two strikes. Hi, Pam, how you doing?
Good, thank you.
What do you do, darling?
I'm a police officer in Miami. I'm a detective. I do investigations.
Wow. Have you ever seen the show 48 Hours?
Yes, I have.
Yeah, they're big in Miami.
Yes, they are. Yeah.
Name something of his wife that a man might secretly use.
A girdle.
Good answer.
Good
Very
answer.
Good.
Yeah.
All right.
A girdle. Brown family, name something of his wife's that a man might secretly use.
I think I got it.
Okay.
So.
That's good. Soap.
So. Woman soap.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Woman soap. Yes. That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
Oh, yeah. The woman soap. Number four. Okay, who is this guy? Okay. Number five. Number six. Her makeup. Number seven. Her perfume. I got news for you. That's not your man. Top seven answers on the board, fellas. Here we go. Name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores. Jeff.
A kiss.
A kiss.
Yeah! We're playing.
We're gonna play. Sandra, name something the wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
Sex.
Sex.
Woo! Yeah!
Sex.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Hey, Vanessa.
Hi.
Name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes chores.
Pat on the back.
Pat on the back. Steven, what's up, man?
How you doing, Steve?
Good, good. Let's go, man. Name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
More chores.
Some more chores, yeah.
Yeah!
Karina, name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
A hot meal.
A hot meal. Hey, Jeff, something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
Let's him take a nap.
Okay.
Let's him take a nap. Sandra, only one strike. Name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
A drink.
Yeah. A drink.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Vanessa, one answer left. You can clear the board. Something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
Money.
Yeah. Fellas, when last time your wife gave you some money for anything?
Come on.
Money!
Come on.
Steven, one answer left, two strikes. Jackson family can steal. Name something a wife gives a husband after he finishes chores.
I'm gonna say the night off.
The night off! Oh, the night off! That was a good answer, man. Name something a wife gives her husband after he finishes his chores.
Steve, we're gonna go with a massage.
Wow. A massage! Let's go to question two. Give me Drew. Give me Michael.
What's the word, turd?
Wow, you guys all got one-liners. Yep. I didn't prepare mine. You suck.
I'm a songwriter. Wow.
All right, fellas, top eight answers on the board. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Lottery ticket.
Lottery.
The winning the lottery. Winning it.
Yo, won't be no gambling in heaven, I don't think. Lottery ticket. Drew.
A halo.
A halo.
Yeah!
Let's go. Let's go. Good job, baby. I'm gonna take you here. All right, Roy. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Angel wings.
Good.
Angel wings. Yeah,
nice. At least I said something.
Angel wings.
I got this.
Matt, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Food.
Food.
Come on. That's gotta be one. Yeah.
Food.
Yeah!
Craig, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Like a pet or a dog?
A pet or a dog.
Yeah!
Okay, yeah.
Boom!
Okay, Alex, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A loved one.
Yeah. A loved one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's for real. Yeah. A loved one. Hey, Drew, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A new car. I don't know. Yeah.
Hey.
A car. All right, Roy, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
The answers.
That has to be one.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Come on.
The answers. All right, Matt.
Come on, boys.
We got two strikes. Got to be careful. 5 seconds of summer can steal. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A jar of heaven. A jar of memories.
A jar of memories.
He's a songwriter.
I had that. Come on.
A jar of memories.
The hell is that?
It's all I had, Alex. It's all I had.
It's God. He knows everything. He ain't putting nothing in jars.
Shouldn't have agreed to this today.
You're not gonna be in the band.
I know. Come on.
Jar of memories. All right, fellas, here's your chance. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
I just got to heaven. I want the coldest beer of all time.
A cold beer.
Yeah!
Number eight.
Oh,
seven. Over 300 points, so don't go away. We'll be back with more Celebrity Family Feud. Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 married women. If your man was in jail, name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him. Chris.
Naked pictures.
Naked pictures.
Darling. A picture of me.
A what?
A picture of me.
A picture of me. Picture of me. Kiki.
Lingerie.
Lingerie.
Yes.
Lingerie.
Oh my God.
Stephanie.
Cigarettes.
Cigarettes, please. You playing, just come on. Got no time for this. What the hell are you finna pass for? Sitting up in here like you finna guess the right answer. 100 married women, if your man was in jail, name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him.
A love note, a love letter.
A love note. Come on, Kaylee. You married, now your husband's in jail. Name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him.
A cell phone.
Hey, Michelle, your husband's in jail. Name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him.
Alcohol.
Alcohol. Yeah. All right, we got 2 strikes now. We got to be careful. It's your family. You can't steal. We ask 100 married women. Your man was in jail. Name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him.
Drugs.
Yeah. Drugs! Stephanie?
Yes, sir.
2 strikes. Fisher family can steal. Please. Please. Talk to your 100 married women. If your man was in jail, name something you might hide in the birthday cake you baked for him.
A gun.
A gun!
That was a good one.
Here's your chance. Talk to 100 married women. If your man was in jail, name something you might hide in the birthday cake you bake for him.
We're gonna say money.
Money.
Money! And mate. Seven.
Candy.
5.
Play and shame.
So he can get some more time. 3.
Fire.
All right, ladies. Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 married women, name something you've been tempted to do to your husband when he's fast asleep.
Hit him.
Hit him.
Good answer. Good answer.
Hit him.
Check his phone.
Check. Wow. Check his phone. Pass the play.
We're
going to
play.
Madison, 100 married women, name something you've been tempted to do your husband when he's asleep.
Kiss him.
Kiss him. Well, I'll tell you what. I ain't gonna be sleep no more. Scott, talk to 100 married women. Something you've been tempted to do to your husband when he's asleep.
Uncle Steve, I'm gonna say just Wake him up, you know? Wake him up.
Wake him up. Wake him up. Lynn, 100 married women. Something you've been tempted to do your husband when he's asleep.
I might take a picture of him.
Take a picture. Come on now, we got two strikes, family. Let's pick it up a little bit. Haywoods Castile. Name something you've been tempted to do to your husband when he's asleep.
Going old school, Steve. Before the phone, you gotta go through his pockets.
Go through his pockets. A 100 married women, name something you've been tempted to do to your husband when he's fast asleep.
Prank him.
Prank him. Number 8.
Pistols.
7.
Draw.
Number 4.
Tickle.
Number 3.
Push out
of bed. 2.
Wow.
Number 1. If someone's in the bathroom longer than 5 minutes, name something they might be doing.
Cleaning it.
Cleaning it. Hey, Megan.
Hi.
Young Megan just graduated from high school, started your own charity.
I did start my own charity. That was good.
Anything else you want to tell me about yourself?
I'm going to be a third grade religious education teacher in the fall.
Third grade religious education teacher?
Yeah, like CCD classes.
You're going to be a Sunday school teacher?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what that is. I'm going to teach religious Sunday school teacher. No, I know, because my mom was a
Sunday
school.
It's not taught on Sundays. It's taught Mondays.
It's not taught on Sundays. Well, yeah. Where's you? Well, then you're a Monday school teacher.
I'm a Monday school teacher, yes.
You just teach them religious stuff.
Exactly.
Well, what you do is on Mondays, you just teach them what sins you commit after Sunday.
Exactly.
That's all it is.
Exactly.
A piece of cake.
There's so many.
I could teach that class.
Yeah. I'm about to say one right now, actually.
You're about to say one what?
A sin that you could commit between Sunday and Monday.
Well, what sin is that?
Playing with yourself. In the bathroom.
Oh, that's the answer. Jesus. That's your answer.
I really couldn't think of anything
else. God, we're going to hell. I was only kidding.
You can come to fucking school.
Shut up. You can come to Sunday school. We're going to be discussing it on Monday. What are you talking about? You're taking the joke too far.
Yeah, my mom's in the audience, too.
Well.
And my grandparents.
Where's the mom? That's your daughter. So the question was, if someone's in the bathroom longer than 5 minutes, name something they might be doing, and your answer is playing with something. Whatever it is, I've never done that. Or what it is. Playing with yourself. All right, guys, let's go. We've doubled the point values here. Top 7 answers on the board. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing. Jeff.
Sister. She's never gonna forgive me for this either.
No, she's not.
Lindsay, you're not the sister.
No.
Where's your sister right now, Joe?
Probably hiding somewhere.
Is she in the building?
Or hunting for a weapon.
They got a new device now. It's called YouTube. You're gonna be a major star, Joe.
I'm sure.
him. His sister. Well, you got seven other people gonna be in the same room in hell with you. 20.
A pillow.
A pillow? Wow. Oh, pillow. Oh, okay.
Wow. They're gonna play.
They're gonna play. Yeah. Hey, Jeff. Hang in there, man. That was a good answer. I've never heard that. I didn't know that. It's really smart. Heidi, when you were a kid, name something you used as a partner for practicing kissing.
Use your hand.
Oh. I'm sorry. I was so somewhere else. Use your hand. Ooh. Oh, no. Kenzie, let's go. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
I'm gonna say a stuffed animal.
Wow. A stuffed animal. This is actually fascinating to me. Because I don't know any of this. The pillow really threw me off. And it was number one. So, hey, Taffy, let's go.
I'm gonna go with another neighbor kid.
One of the neighbors. Come here, boy. Ramsey, let's go. Only one strike. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
A doll.
There you go, man.
A doll. Guys are rolling. 20, it all started with you and the pillow.
Sounds a little strange, but how about the mirror?
Good answer.
The mirror. Y'all was having a good time. No wonder y'all pregnant. Y'all just so ready to try everything. Been all in the mirror down there with the little girl down next door. You got a baby doll in your hand. Come here, give me that animal right here. You just been in the house practicing. Woo. I bet y'all stuffed animals is laying on the bed like, yeah. Oh, yeah. I got to be the luckiest bear in the world. Because you're all attractive girls. I'm sitting at y'all's house going, what a life. Hey, Steve, what are you? I'm a stuffed animal. Don't you wish you were something else? Uh-uh. They'll be home in a minute. What y'all working on today? We doing pregnancy today. You only got one strike, but you only got one answer left. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
We're going to say a sucker.
Good answer. Good job.
This explains it. You know this explains it, don't you? Y'all got all the answers. That's on the board. I won't. A sucker! Oh. Two strikes, McKins. You gotta be careful. Pippin family can steal. Yeah, go on, say it. I wanna hear this.
Orange.
An orange? What? What y'all doing at your house? You got a pillow? You got this poor baby doll need therapy. You in the mirror. You using your hands. And that stuffed animal is waiting on y'all to put all that mess down. I'm ready. Come on, baby. Let's do it. And orange. Give me Lacey Von Erich. Give me Mick Foley. Hi, darling.
Hi, Foley.
Here we go. Top five answers on the board, everybody. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with it. Lacey.
Eating nuts.
eating nuts.
Show me nuts. Yeah!
Okay, here's the whole question. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Go ahead, Foley. It's a family show.
Let me see storing them.
Storing?
Yeah!
Wow. Pass or play?
Yeah. I think we're going to pass.
They're going to pass it, ladies.
Wow.
It's a tough one, ladies.
Oh, gosh. That is tough.
Yeah, it is. It is. And it's going to be tougher for me to say this five times. And something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Play?
I'm sorry, guys.
Play with that. Yeah! Good answer! Play with your nuts!
Come on, Steve! Have faith in me. Have faith in me.
I see him doing that all the time.
Yes.
Play with his nuts? Yeah. I do too.
I was talking about Steve.
Playing with them.
Sorry.
Christy?
Okay. Finding them.
Oh, that's good.
Finding them.
Oh. Come on, brother.
Two strikes. If it's not their velvet, the wrestlers are gonna get a chance to steal.
Taking them to its tree.
Taking them to the tree. Two strikes.
Defending his nuts.
Defending them. Here we go. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Cracking them open.
Yeah. Cracking them open. Let's see number five. Scratch. We'll be right back if we still have a show. Point values are triple. Top four answers on the board. We asked 100 men, name something you don't want unless it's big.
Boobs.
Big boobs, yeah. All right.
Butt.
Big butt. Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
Let's go, darling. Sean, 100 men, name something you don't want unless it's big.
I'm gonna go with a house.
Big house. Eric, 100 men, name something you don't want unless it's big.
Bank account.
Big bank, baby. Hey, Kayla, name something, 100 men. Now, name something they don't want unless it's big.
A car?
That's me. I like big cars. All right, Eric, look, Alex, listen to me. We got two strikes. We ask 100 men to name something you don't want unless it's big.
Say a steak, Steve.
A big steak. Kristen, one answer left. If it's not there, the other family could steal and play sudden death.
Steve, I'm gonna say promotion. Big promotion.
This is for the win. Promotion! Family, one answer left. One answer only. If it's there, your family steals, your family gets to play sudden death. If it's not there, the Robinson family wins the game. Talk to 100 men. Name something you don't want unless it's big.
Penis. Yeah.
They don't want it unless it's the big man part. Number two. Name something that has white balls. Derek.
Ping pong.
Ping pong. One answer.
Yeah. Golf.
Golf. Pass or play?
We're gonna pass, Steve.
You're gonna, boy, y'all do that a lot. They're gonna
pass.
All right. Hey, Michelle.
Steve,
how you doing?
I'm doing very well.
So how's it been married to this soldier for 21 years?
It's been absolutely fabulous, Steve.
All right, Michelle, let's go. Name something that has white balls.
I would say softball.
Softball. Yeah! Kim, how you doing?
Wonderful. Good. How are you, Steve?
All right, Kim, name something that has white balls.
Cotton. Cotton balls.
All right, big fella, name something that has white balls.
I'm gonna say polo.
Polo.
That's right, polo.
Polo. Mel, how you doing, darling?
Great, how are you?
Good, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
You got two strikes, you gotta be careful. Finch family can steal. Name something that has white balls.
Foosball.
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 Foosball. Taffy. All right, here's your chance, ladies. Name something that has white balls.
Volleyball.
I don't know. Volleyball. Number seven.
Pool table.
Six. That's the worst answer we've ever flipped over, man. I was thinking it, but I was hoping it wasn't up there. Number five.
Christmas tree ornament.
Three.
Snowman.
Point values are triple, fellas. Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Name something that is sexier when it's in black. Marco.
Lingerie.
Lingerie, yeah. Bianca.
Yes, sir.
Name something that is sexier when it's in black.
Stilettos.
Stilettos. Julie, name something that is sexier when it's in black.
Dress.
You better know it. Dress. Yeah! Keelys. Name something that is sexier when it's in black.
A car.
Yeah, black car. Jessica, one answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game. Name something that is sexier when it's in black.
A hat.
A hat. A hat. Marcos, one answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game. Name something that is sexier when it's in black.
People.
Boy, let me tell you something. Boy, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, Marcos.
Yes!
It might not be up there, but that's a damn good answer. People. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date. Taffy.
Condom.
Condom. It's okay. It's a hot date. Condom.
We're gonna play.
They're gonna play. Ramsey, tell me something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
He's gotta have money.
Gotta have money. Twani?
I'm not walking, so we better have some keys.
Better have some car keys. Heidi, only one strike, darling. Tell me something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
Breath mints.
Breath mints. Hey, Mackenzie, darling.
This may be inappropriate, but maybe he's excited to go on his date.
Uh-huh.
I have to be more specific, don't I?
Yeah, because I ain't never put no excitement in my pants. Go ahead, Mackenzie.
Boner.
Huh?
I'm really upset again?
What did you say?
Boner.
You can say this on TV? You can say that on TV? You can say that on TV? What are y'all clapping for? You said boner. You said it. You didn't ask me if you could say that. You said it, and then you said, do I have to make you say it again? I didn't make you say it in the first place. Let's get this clear. This was Little Miss Fassie's answer. Oh, this show ain't gonna make it 3 years. I'm gonna be off the air. When Richard Dawson did this show, I never heard stuff like this. I don't remember any of this. Now, 2011, 2012, y'all just say what you wanna say. Now I gotta turn around. I've gotta find a Christian way to say what you just said. Let's just say someone is saluting the troops. Let me tell y'all something. Look at the last one that just went up. A pitch tent. Don't say that when you come out the hole. Ready, break. All right, Taffy. Wow. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
I'm gonna say some cologne. So you keep smelling nice.
Some cologne. Ramsey, you gotta be careful, Dolly. You got 2 strikes. Walkers, have a chance to steal.
Chapstick?
Good answer!
Chapstick! Walkers, you're gonna have to come up with it. Here's your chance. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
We're gonna go with the hotel room key.
Yes! Yeah! Yeah! A hotel room key. Number 6.
A sock.
Number 4. This poor guy.
Wallet.
Something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma.
Naked, huh?
I don't want to see that either.
I know you're right, okay? Nobody wants to see a naked grandma, but what are the chances of you breaking in the house and running up into your grandmama naked? Looking for a naked grandmama in the house, outside, in the woods, on the blanket. That's the occupant person that's there. Point values have doubled. Here we go. Top 6 answers are on the board. Name something that follows the word pork.
Lawn.
Huh?
Lawn. Pork lawn. L-I-O-N. Lawn.
Oh.
Pork lawn.
Glad you spelled it, because I'm... The hell is a pork lawn? I thought you said lawn like the grass outside. I was going, what the hell is a pork lawn? Lawn! Looking for the pork lawn.
Yeah.
Joe,
Pork belly.
Pork belly.
We're gonna play.
What am? Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
Huh? You pine. Pork pine.
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Yes! That's my tank!
Yes! Little tank!
Pork. He said, cupine.
Cupine.
What? What is cupine? This is the greatest answer I've ever heard. No, I feel you. It's number one.
Oh, my mama.
Pow. It's number one. Oh, really? Well, I tell you what, it's gonna be number one on YouTube, but it ain't gonna be number one up there. I bet every dollar I got, you the only person that said cupine. Cupid! Name something people hope.
That they go to heaven.
That they go to heaven. Wait till you hear the rest of this question. Look at me.
Okay.
Name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed. Debbie?
Pee.
Wow. Pee. Pee.
They're gonna play.
Hey, they're gonna play.
It's a long walk, Steve.
Yeah, it is.
It's a long walk.
Oh, God, look who I'm talking to. Oh, this ought to be good right here. Name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed, Andrew.
Steve, I had to quit inviting people to my house because they wouldn't stop masturbating.
I told you at the beginning of the show that it was just of my opinion that your son was involved in drugs. Where we at now? Kind of feeling me a little bit now, Miss Lee?
Yes, sir.
Doing the nasty thing in the bedroom. It's a form of it. It's just you're alone.
I only invited one person.
I know, Andrew. Just shut up. I know. Miss Lynn, name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Get sick in the bed, like throw up.
Get sick in the bed. Get sick in the bed. Only one strike. Donna, name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Well, I'll say cutting their toenails.
Oh, good answer.
I agree.
Yeah.
Cutting their toenails. Two strikes, Whitney. You saved the day before, though.
Eat in the bed.
Hope they don't eat in the bed. Eat in the bed.
Yeah.
Whitney,
yeah.
You keep pulling them out. She's a good player. Two strikes there, Debbie.
Their pet in the bed.
Great.
Especially her pet. Keep the pet out of the bed.
Jump in the bed.
Joyce, give me something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Jump in the bed.
Hope they don't jump in the bed.
Good answer.
J. jump in the bed. Number four. Folks, here we go. We got the top seven answers on the board. Name something you put in your mouth but don't swallow. Amanda.
Gum.
Gum.
We're gonna play safe.
They gonna play. Yeah. Megan, tell me something you put in your mouth but you don't swallow. Wow. You ever walked up to somebody and saw the look on their face and you just know? I walked up to her and I went, whoa. I mean, man, you talk about the cat that ate the canary look. Megan, I'm gonna ask you a question. I want you to think about this show and all the years it's aired, how many families have enjoyed this wonderful form of Christian entertainment. So find a way to give me your answer and keep it where we can all be working when you're done.
Well, I'm a pastor's wife, but I will say this out loud, they're sperm. You know it's up there, Steve. Everyone knew it. It's up there. We're going for the money.
We're going for the money, so that makes it all right. It doesn't matter that I'm a pastor's wife. Ticket to hell is worth $20,000. You know it's up there, Steve. No, I don't know a damn thing is up there. What you ain't gonna do is drag me into your little nasty world. I don't know nothing is up there. Oh, Steve, you know what's up there. How the hell I know what's up there? I have kids. Now. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, 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 yeah. It ain't up there, yeah. Now, it ain't up there, yeah. Hey, it ain't up there, yes. Yes, we can all still probably go to heaven. All right. Hey, 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 uh-huh, uh-huh. And what you get for saying it? You gonna stay on the air. Family Feud, 20 more years. Richard Dawson, we love you, man. All right, guys, here we go. We got the top six answers on the board. Name something that gets passed around. Oh, Chris.
A joint.
A joint.
It's coming in. Can I leave?
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Now, Chris, I don't know what 100 people you thought we were talking to at some nice little mall across good old America, but I'm pretty sure the people didn't tell the survey people, hey, an illegal drug. Let's turn around and see how many weed heads are out there with Chris. A joint. This is when you know we're going to hell. Okay, Tracy, only four answers topic, so.
The collection played at church.
Yeah.
Now she's got the halo, you know, and I got the horns.
I like the way you tried to stop us from going to hell. That's, you, Mr. You Evil Boy, passing around the little thing with this funny smell, looking for some saving here. Church plate. It's less than the joint. This is not good. I'm just gonna do, you just go over there. They're gonna play this.
Yes, we are.
Can't believe you said that on TV like that. Your mama over there.
I know, my mama and my daddy.
And your daddy over there.
My daddy gonna kill me.
Yeah, my daddy gonna kill me? Well, he ain't gonna kill you if it's number one, but I don't know if it's number one. Well, here she goes. First time on national TV, Beverly says she doesn't care if a guy is short as long as he's packing. Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Fill in the blank with one word. Knock blank.
Knock down.
Knock down.
Knock knock.
Knock knock. Well, finally got over here on this side. Y'all doing all right today?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's go. Deron, how you feeling today, man?
Feeling good, Steve.
All right, brother. Fill in the blank with one word. Knock blank.
Knocked up.
Knocked up. Fill in the blank with one word. Knock blank.
Knock out.
Knockout. Melinda, here's the situation. There's one answer left on the board. If it's there, your family wins the game. Melinda, fill in the blank with one word. Knock blank.
Knock in.
Knock in! Queen Wanda, one answer left. Queen, if you give me that answer, your family wins the game, but this time we got two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and they will win the game.
Knock on.
Good answer. Good answer.
Knock on for the win. All right, family. Here's the situation.
This is my answer, Steve.
This is your answer?
My
man.
Probably wrong.
Yeah, if y'all take his answer, you need a whipping. If it's there, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the other family wins the game. Fill in the blank with one word. Knock blank.
Knock back, Steve.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the win. Knock back for the win. Number four. One answer left. You can clear the board, Q. Some politicians belong in the White House, others belong in the blank house.
Well, Steve, if they're good, they belong in the White House.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Keep it right there.
Yeah, just like that, the question.
What's
Yes, sir.
I might not get you, but I bet this ain't up there. Some politicians belong in the White House. Others belong in the White House. Oh, that's clever right there. Oh, they're trying to trick me. Listen to me. Some politicians belong in the White House. Others belong in the White House.
In the White House.
That's so damn funny. That's a good answer. What's your question? I'm gonna tell you the same thing you asked me. White, yeah. Oh, that's a good answer right there. Here we go. I'm finna point. Ready? Hold your breath. Some politicians belong in the White House. Others belong in the White House. In the White House. I was dragging a minute ago. God saw me having a rough day.
Oh, yeah.
God decided to lift me up.
Yes.
He said,
what?
You need an answer.
Yes.
That ain't really an answer.
Oh, yes.
You need an answer.
Yes.
That's really a question.
Well, yes.
I'm gonna answer the question.
Yes.
With a question.
Yes.
Some politicians belong in the White House.
Yes.
Others belong in the White House.
Yes.
Can I tell you something else?
You can tell me something else.
Is this your brother-in-law?
That's my brother-in-law.
Your brother-in-law about to be on YouTube. Hey.
What?
All right, top six answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank. All right. Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year. I'm gonna let that sink in for a minute. My wife actually feels that way. But she the only one, so. Fill in the blank. Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he'd win Blankest Man of the Year.
Funniest.
Funniest. Goofiest is not a word that applies to me. You can't be goofy and have swag at the same time. And Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he win Blankest Man of the Year.
Baldest?
Baldest. I guess that means I have less hair than anybody. Angela? Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he win Blankest Man of the Year.
Best dressed.
Best dressed. Best dressed. Abby?
Steve
Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year. I can't even say that without laughing. Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he win Blankest Man of the Year.
Somewhere out there, you are the richest man of the year. Yeah! Woo! Yeah. Yeah.
Richest. All right, Cindy, Steve Harvey was robbed for winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he win Blankest Man of the Year.
I would say the kindest.
The kindest.
Oh!
All right, we got two strikes, Karen. Gibson family can steal. Steve Harvey's robbed winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he win Blankest Man of the Year.
Buffest? Is that the same thing as...
No, good in hell, well. Buffest.
Come on, Steve.
Buffest. Yoked up. Buffest. Steve Harvey was robbed from winning Sexiest Man of the Year, but he'd win Blankest Man of the Year.
Hardest working man of the year, Steve.
Hardest working man of the year. Number six.
Smartest.
I've never heard that before. Number five.
Blackest.
Bam. Yeah. All day, baby. Black man of the year. I'll take it. You can clap. It's okay. There wasn't nothing. Number four.
Coolest.
All day. Top seven answers on the board. You can't practice for this game. Got another one for you. Fill in the blank. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
Mosquito bite.
Mosquito bite.
Mole?
A mole. They're gonna play. Fill in the blank. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
A bruise, Steve.
A bruise. Yeah. Elizabeth, when trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
That's just some dirt.
That hickey, that's just some dirt. Just some red and blue dirt. Becca, when trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank. Do you know what a hickey is?
Me personally, no. But I know what a hickey is. I know what a hickey is.
Cause she's struggling with this answer right here. Little girl, when trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
Paint.
That's just some paint. Some paint. All right, Chelsea, we got two strikes. You got to be careful, McFarlane family can steal. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
A burn.
That's a burn. Toria, two strikes, all the family can steal. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
A rash.
A rash. Two strikes, McFarlane family can steal. Come on, superhero. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
Some makeup, Steve.
Good answer.
Some makeup. Fill in the blank. When trying to explain a hickey, you might say, oh, that's just a blank.
That's just a cut.
That's just a cut. Number seven. Three. Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 women to fill in the blank. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
Can't make rent.
Can't make rent.
We're gonna play Steve.
You're gonna play. Jacques.
I'm here for you, Steve. Talk to me.
Jacques. Oh, I wasn't finished.
Okay, go ahead.
Jacques. Quiz. We ask 100 women fill in the blank. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
I'm gonna say, you know, ladies let her eat and love a man that cooks, so food only makes sense to me.
That's good.
You know? What is the answer?
Cook, food, but can't cook.
Oh, okay, cook. Well, you know, we just need one answer.
Oh, my bad, I had to stop thinking.
You don't gotta pick what you said out of a damn paragraph.
Let's go.
Food! Rainy, like a rainy day?
Yes.
Fill in the blank. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
I need my parents to cover y'all ears, but if a man can't make love, I will leave him.
Ooh, yeah. Whoa. Make love! Yeah. Raven, if a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
So she took mine.
Okay.
I'm gonna say if a man can't make my car go, I'm gonna jump him. If he can't make my car run right, yep. I'm gonna jump him. Yeah. I was just that one. Make my car run. If he can't make my car.
Can't make my car run.
Yeah.
Next, can't make the car run. James, sir, if a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
I'm gonna say time.
Oh. If a man can't make time, I'll dump him. We only got one strike. Hey, it's your turn again. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
Like maintenance, you know, if he can't take care of the house, I've got to dump him. Like, fix a light bulb, like, if he can't make things with his hands.
Yeah.
Things work.
Fix stuff in the house. All right, Jacques, we got two strikes. You got to be careful, the other family can steal. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
Make you laugh.
If a man can't make me laugh, I'll dump him. Rainy, like a day, we got two strikes, one answer left, you clear the board. But this time, the family can steal.
If a man can't make a drink, I'll dump him.
Okay, good one.
Gotta be a bartender. Can't make a drink, I'm out. Fill in the blank. If a man can't make blank, I'll dump him.
Make me look good?
If a man can't make me look good, number six. Top six answers on the board. No man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
Go shopping.
Go shopping.
Go to sleep.
Go to sleep.
Like go to bed.
LT? No man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
We need to talk, Steve!
We need to talk. No man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
We need to take care of the baby.
We need a baby! No man likes to hear, we need to take care of the baby. Just let it lay over there in the floor. It'll be fine. Let the baby crawl for food.
Wow.
We need to take care of the baby, Jesus. Lexis, no man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
Get a divorce.
bunch of times.
You didn't like it, did you?
It's up there!
You better believe it. Divorce. No man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
We need to clean.
We need to clean.
Clean the house. Clean the house.
Albert, no man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
We need to go to the bank.
Oh, yeah.
We need to go to the bank. LT, one answer left. You got only one strike. No man likes to hear a woman say we need to blank.
We need to move the parents in.
Oh! Yeah. We need to move the parents in. Yeah. Oh. All right, we got two strikes. Now the Martin family can steal. No man likes to hear a woman say we need to blank.
We need to go to the moon.
Moon. No man likes to hear a woman say, we need to blank.
Have more kids.
We need to have more kids. Number six. Top four answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank, and you must match exactly. Here we go. Shut your blank.
Mouth.
Shut your mouth. Let's go. Mark, shut your blank.
Shut your fly.
Shut your fly. Ken, shut your blank.
I'm gonna say shut your door, Steve.
Shut your door.
Yeah. Ah. Come on, Britt.
All right, y'all gotta get together now. We got two strikes. If it's not there, the Barber family can steal and win. Brittany, shut your blank.
Shut your pie hole?
Shut. Shut your pie hole. We could have played this game for 2 weeks in a row. I wouldn't have got that. Two strikes. If it's there, you're still alive. But because of the two strikes, if it's not there, the other team can steal and they will win the game. Armani, shut your blank.
All right, Steve. Shut your life.
Shut your life. All right, family, here's the situation. I got two answers left on this board. If either answer's there, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the Cooper family wins the game. Here we go. Fill in the blank, and you must match exactly. Shut your blank.
Shut your trap.
Shut your trap for the win. Number three. All right, ladies, top seven answers on the board. Listen to me closely. This is fill in the blanks. If a woman had to choose between a man and her blank, she'd choose her blank.
Money.
Money.
Her kids.
Kids.
We're gonna play?
We're gonna play. Hey, Alex.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Y'all from Loganville, Georgia.
You know it.
We love everybody.
What do you do for a living?
I stay home with my two beautiful girls.
Okay.
And next month, I'll have three beautiful girls.
You're 8 months pregnant?
I am.
That's creepy.
She carries one.
I thought your stomach pose was out there.
Sorry. There we go. I'm also a fitness instructor.
All the world.
One of those.
Oh, but y'all mad though. Oh. So you just gonna be cute for the whole pregnancy. Mandy, how you doing?
I am wonderful, Steve. How are you?
All right, here we go. Fill in the blanks. If a woman had to choose between a man and her blank, she'd choose her blank.
Job.
Job. Hey, Miss Lisa, fill in the blanks. If a woman had to choose between a man and her blank, she'd choose a blank.
Her bank account.
Bank account. That's the same as,
well, that would be that
the
one,
same
probably.
As money. That's all right. Speed, fill in the blanks. If a woman had to choose between a man and her blank, she'd choose a blank.
I'm gonna go with car.
Man and a car, she'd choose a car. We gotta slow it down. Now, hold on. Come on, family. Look, slow it down. We got two strikes. Gotta be careful. Wilkins family can steal.
Home? Home. Home.
House, maybe.
Home! Fill in the blanks. If a woman had to choose between a man and her blank, she'd choose her blank.
All right, Steve. The ladies love their heels, so we're gonna go with shoes.
Shoes! Number five.
First.
Four. Three. Wow.
Best friends.
One. Top seven answers on the board. Fill in the blank. The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
IV.
IV.
Checkup.
Checkup. Tanya.
A spanking.
Spanking. Dan.
Hearing test.
A hearing test.
A pill.
A pill.
Yeah.
A pill. Sarah. Oh,
take their temperature.
Take the temperature.
Good answer.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Hey, Veronica.
It's so nice to meet you, Steve. We were looking forward to this all our lives.
Really?
Well, I don't know, but like we were really looking forward to this.
No, I like, just lie to me. I like that. Just stay with me. All of our lives, yeah. What do you do for a living?
Okay, so I'm so blessed because I get to be a full-time mommy to my spirited child, Hannah Elizabeth, and I am happily married to my spicy husband, Santiago.
You got a husband named Santiago.
And you have to say it like that, Santiago.
I know Santiago. Something got to be happening at this house. Santiago. Yeah. All right, introduce everybody.
Okay, well, here is my tenacious sister, Tanya. And then my incredible cousin, Irene. My magnificent sister, Magdalena. And last but not least, my bodacious cousin, Brittany.
That's pretty good. Well, let's play the game.
I'm next.
All right. No. All right, let's go.
All right, let's do this.
Ma'am?
Yes.
The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A bath.
A bath. Brittany?
Hi.
The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A blood pressure check.
Blood pressure. Veronica, the nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A urine sample?
Good answer!
A urine sample? All right, we got two strikes, Tanya. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
Immunizations. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Immunizations. Congratulations. Two strikes. We got to be careful. Irene, hi.
Yes. Hi.
The nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A foot rub.
A foot rub.
Magdalena.
You know, if you give me a chance. Jeez, as soon as I say Magdalena. Yes. You done got tired of people messing your name up.
Maybe.
Okay. Well, other family can steal. Nurse got fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
A pillow.
A pillow. The nurse was fired for making patients undress just to give them a what?
Pulse check.
Check your pulse.
Good answer.
Number seven.
Bam!
Number five. Top five answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women, fill in the blank. The rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
Shoot him.
Shoot him. Your husband's here?
He is. He's very faithful.
He's very faithful.
Very.
Well, hell yeah. I guess he is. You know, so that ain't the first time you'd have made this statement. Shoot him.
I leave him.
Leave. Pass the point. Love her. So I kill him. So, bing, kill him. Stop all that. Bye. Dee Dee, what do you do?
Well, for all of the 70s and into the 80s, I was the secretary at the Whiskey A Go Go nightclub in Hollywood.
Girl, down on Sunset?
Yes. I worked with a lot of really wonderful people like Stevie Wonder and Tom Petty and Blondie, and I had my 21st birthday with Led Zeppelin. Yes.
Man, that's cool.
Well, it
man.
Does kind of run in with what I do now.
Okay, what is that?
For the last 10 years, I have been the detention supervisor at a middle school for the public school system. So you see, I know how to handle naughty boys.
That's pretty good, man. That's an interesting story.
Thank you.
All right, Chuck. Talk to 100 women. Fill in the blank. Rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
Beat him.
Beat him. up, Cassie?
Hi.
Fill in the blank. The rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
Cheat on him.
I cheat on him. Yeah. I cheat on him. All right, Cindy.
Hi.
Fill in the blank. The rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
I'm gonna burn all his stuff.
And based on all the women in here, that's a good answer. Burn all his stuff. Oh, we got one answer left. You clear the board, talk to 100 women, fill in the blank. Rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
I sabotage him.
I sabotage him. All right, DD, one answer left. Clear the board. But we got two strikes the Noah family can steal. The rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
I forgive him.
All the women in the room went. I forgive him. Talk to 100 women, fill in the blank. The rules are simple. If a man cheats on me, I blank him.
Beat up the mistress.
Thing I like about Mama Tarina is she didn't go to the kids for that answer at all. Now, she done already killed him. That was her first answer. Now, she whooping somebody's ass now. Beat up the mistress. Top 8 answers on the board, fellas. We asked 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
Kid.
Kid.
No place for you.
This is a great question because our beloved warm-up man drives a Tesla. Oh. Brand new. Cash. I told you the boy was rich, didn't I? All right, good. Introduce everybody, Britt.
This is my oldest daughter, Tiffany, my son, Andrew, my daughter, Hallie, and my beautiful wife, Mona. Most amazing thing about these three, they put up with me as a single dad for most of their lives. When I got divorced and I got custody, Tiffany was 10, Andrew was 6, Hallie was 4.
Wow.
Today, they're all college graduates and doing fantastic.
Oh, that's good, man. All right, let's go. Tiffany, we asked 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
Too bad I'm gonna hit it.
I'm gonna hit it. Hey, Andrew, we talked to 100 women. My ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
I'm gonna slash those tires.
Slash yeah. the tires. Yeah, we asked 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
I'm gonna steal it.
I'm gonna steal it. Okay, Mona, we asked 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
Cut the brakes.
Yeah. Cut the brakes. Uh-huh. Cut the brakes. Brett, we asked 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad I'm gonna do what to it?
My wife would drive it.
Too bad I'm gonna drive it.
That's a good answer.
Tiffany.
That was good.
We ask 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad, I'm gonna do what to it?
I'm gonna pour paint all over it.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Well, why though? Pour paint all over it. All right, Andrew, we got to be careful. We got 2 strikes. Now, Hollister family can steal. We talked to 100 women. My ex just got a Tesla. Too bad. I'm going to do what to it?
I'm going to crash it.
Yep.
I'm going to crash it. Hallie, 2 strikes. Hollister family can steal. Talk to 100 women. Mm-hmm. My ex just got a Tesla. Too bad. I'm going to do what to it?
I'm going
to
set it on fire.
Good answer. Yes. Ready to exhale.
You know what? Y'all's answers are very, very mean. Set it on fire. We ask 100 women, my ex just got a Tesla. Too bad. I'm going to do what to it?
Break those windows.
Bust out all the windows. Number 6.
Take it out.
Top 6 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something a farmer does to a cow that he would hate the cow to do to him.
Milk it.
Milk it. They're gonna play. Name something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate for the cow to do to him.
I'm gonna have to go with feed him, Steve.
Feed him. Miss Robin, name something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate the cow to do to him.
Slaughtering?
Slaughtering. Name something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate for the cow to do to him.
Skin him.
Skinny. All right, we got 2 strikes now, Cameron. We got to slow it down. Hernandez family can steal. Something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate to have a cow do to him.
I'm going to go with brand the cow. Yes.
Brand him. Carson, 2 strikes. Let's be careful. Other family can steal. Name something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate for the cow to do to him.
Smack his butt.
Smack his butt. Cam Carson said, "Woo! You knew it was up there." No, I didn't. I don't know if anybody knew that one. All right, Kate, we got 2 strikes. Got to be careful, buddy. Name something a farmer does to a cow he'd hate for the cow to do to him.
I'd hate it if he sold me. Sell him.
If he sold me. Something a farmer does to a cow to eat for the cow to do to him.
Our family's gonna go with eating it.
Hate for it to eat it. Number 5.
Yes,
4. Point values are double. We got top 7 answers on the board. Fill in the blank. Blank daddy.
Mama.
Mama, daddy.
Good answer. Good answer. That was a good answer. That was a good answer. Come on. Good answer, Steve. It's up there.
Blank daddy, mama.
Granddaddy. Baby daddy.
Wow.
Baby daddy.
Baby daddy. Jimmy.
Sugar daddy.
Come on, boy. Sugar daddy.
We gonna play.
Come on, come on. I didn't think baby daddy was gonna be up there. Nah, that was really good, though. Sugar daddy, I knew was up there. Amy, blank daddy.
Big daddy.
Big daddy! I've been all these so far. I'm all of them right now. Chris, blank daddy.
I'm gonna go with my daddy.
My daddy! Greg, blank daddy.
Uh-oh, the only thing I can think of is good daddy.
Good daddy.
Good daddy. Good daddy.
We got one strike, oh. Kathy. Blank daddy.
Hot dog.
Hot dog daddy.
Hot daddy.
Well, Miss Kathy, what would make you say hot dog, Daddy?
Because the family agreed if you couldn't come up with an answer not to say nothing, to say hot dog. So that's what I said, because I couldn't think
there
of an answer.
There you go.
They told me to do it.
Oh, they said if you can't say nothing, just say hot dog.
Say hot dog, so.
Hot dog, Daddy! Oh. Jimmy, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful. Davis family can steal. Blank daddy.
I'm gonna have to say stepdaddy.
Stepdaddy! Blank daddy.
Sexy daddy, Steve. Sexy daddy.
Sexy daddy! Number seven. Number five.
Mac daddy.
Number four.
Go daddy.
I was waiting on you ain't my daddy. This is a fill in the blank. A woman might say bald men are more what?
Ugly.
Older.
Older. No, I'm okay with the older. It's that answer that I heard Sheree.
No.
I heard Cheryl say ugly.
Steve.
No, she said ugly.
I heard her say ugly. I take it back.
She said ugly.
I take it back. Yeah, not you.
You don't have to take it back. She said ugly.
I know.
But it didn't make. If that's up there, damn it, I'm walking out. Now, I'm gonna be a lot of things, but I'm not gonna be the ugliest damn person. Number five.
Lovely
lady.
Yes. That's it.
Yes. Yeah. You can do things with this head.
Yeah, that's right. No, I get it.
See, bald head men, this get in places. Let your mind work with that. Number three. Whatever.
Yes.
We shiny, you dull. Number two.
Fun, shiny.
Hell yeah. All right, guys, top seven answers on the board. Fill in the blank. Well, blank my buns. Henry.
Slap my buns.
Slap my buns.
Kiss.
Kiss my buns.
Steve.
We're gonna play. Crystal, well, blank my buns.
Rub.
Rub.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Christian, only one strike. Well, blank my buns.
Lick.
Lit. Miss Michelle, only one strike. Well, blank my buns.
Toast my buns.
Toast my buns. All right, Chris, just fill in the blank. Blank my buns.
Kick my bun.
Kick it! Kick my bun. All right, now we got two strikes. You got to be careful. The other family can steal, Henry. Well, blank my buns.
Not me, but fill my buns.
Fill my buns. Well, blank my buns.
We're gonna say butter. My buns.
Number seven. Five. This is a fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank her man if she catches him cheating. Elise.
Leave her, man.
Leave.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Introduce everybody.
Okay. So this is my handsome brother, Matt. This is his beautiful wife, Jessica. That's my studious mother, Dr. Sherry Schaefer. And that's my hardworking stepdad, Dave. Yeah.
Sir, how are you?
I'm great.
What's your rank?
I'm a colonel.
I mean, he got to listen to you, and it's not a request. It's an order. That's pretty good. We appreciate y'all's service, gentlemen. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. All right, let's go. Fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank command if she catches him cheating.
I'm going to say murder, Steve.
Murder! It's murder! But you know, the amazing thing was, after he said murder, just all the women started clapping. It was perfect. Yes! Here we go, fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank her man if she catches him cheating.
Steal from him?
Steal, wow, steal from him. Miss Sherry, fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank her man if she catches him cheating.
Slap him.
Slap him! All right, well, let's go, Dave. Fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank her man if she catches him cheating.
Cut him off.
Oh. Cut him off! Yep, no cookie for you, pal. Only one strike, Elise. Fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank her man if she catches him cheating.
How about cheat on him?
Oh. Cheat on him. Payback! One answer left. You can clear the board, Matt. We only got one strike. It's okay for a woman to blank a man if she catches him cheating.
Throw a drink on him.
Throw a drink on him. All right, we got two strikes now, Jessica. We've got to be careful. One answer left. Clear the board. But we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Brown family can steal. It's okay for a woman to blank a man if she catches him cheating.
Set him up. Try to catch him.
Oh, try to catch him.
Yeah.
Try to catch him. All right, guys, fill in the blank. It's okay for a woman to blank a man if she catches him cheating.
Steve, we're gonna go with forgive.
It's okay. None of the women I know are gonna say that. Blank him means she gonna do something. Well, let's see if it's up there. Forgive. Stab. Drag behind the car. Ruin his reputation. Number four. Top five answers on the board. This is a fill in the blank. Blank, hop.
Top.
Top. Top. Top. Top.
Crop top.
Crop top. Crop top hot.
Miss Jocelyn?
Drop top.
Drop top.
Taj.
Big hop.
Big hop.
Well, like, big is the blank,
yeah.
You know?
All right, I got you. Big hop. Marvin.
Bunny hop. Bunny hop.
You all should be ashamed of me. Fill in the blank. Blank hop.
Hip hop.
Thank you. Hip hop. Aaron, fill in the blank. Blank hop.
Car hop.
Car hop. Nick, blank hop.
Mop.
You said mop. Mop. Miss Jocelyn, we got two strikes. We have to be careful. The Kang family can steal.
I hop.
Girl, you better shop. We talking about the pancake house. Marvin, two strikes. Kang family can steal. Marvelous, blank hop.
Dance hop.
Wow. Dance hop. All right, Kim, here's your chance. Blank hop.
Well, we love to bar hop.
Bar hop. I thought that was up there. Number four. Three. Top seven answers on the board. Here we go. Ladies, this is a fill in the blank. If a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
Rich.
Rich. Pass the play.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Hi.
Got it.
Hi.
Hey, Vanessa, how you doing?
Good.
Boy, I like these hats, boy. Y'all
thank
got
you.
That. Got it pimping. I like that.
Yeah.
What do you do, Vanessa?
I am a worship pastor at my dad's church, so he's my boss.
Well, this ought to be good. Introduce everybody, Vanessa.
Okay. This is my awesome husband, Craig, my hilarious dad, Mark, my amazing sister, Natalie, and my talented brother, Adam.
Welcome to the show. Let's go, man. All right, Craig, if a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
Famous.
Famous,
ooh,
yeah.
Oh, that was
Big Daddy Mark, sir, if a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
Sexy. Sexy.
Yeah. And you really ain't got to talk about you cute, because we looking right at you. Hey, Natalie.
Hello.
What do you do?
I am a realtor, a victim's advocate, a writer. I do a little bit of everything.
Really?
Yes.
Well, when you say victims advocate.
Yes, I just try to, I have victims that I work with and that I help through like the court process and that I mentor afterwards,
oh, okay,
and just help families.
Oh, that's pretty
yeah.
good. Cool, all yeah. right, Natalie. If a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
Well, Dad, can you plug your ears?
Well endowed.
Oh. That's a good one, right?
That's a great one.
That's a good one.
Well endowed. Hey, Adam, how you doing, man?
Good, sir. How about yourself?
I like that right there.
Hey, thank you.
Sharp,
thank
you. All right, let's go. Fill in the blank. If a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
Tough.
Tough, ooh. Yeah. That's a true statement. Vanessa, if a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
How about popular?
Popular. All right, we got two strikes the Peyton family can steal, Craig.
How about tall? Brag about your height.
Good answer.
Tall.
That's a good answer.
And in the blank, if a man has to brag about being blank, he probably isn't.
We're gonna go with athletic.
Athletic.
Smart.
Three. Two.
Smart.
Top six answers on the board. Fill in the blank. We asked 100 men. My specialty is making women blank.
Orgasm?
Orgasm. Orgasm.
Smile.
Pass the point.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Latoya, fill in the blank. We ask 100 men. My specialty is making women blank.
Spend their money.
Spend their money. Boy, Lil Leo, we finna find out what the real deal is now. This right up your alley. You probably know all these. See, we fill in the blank. We have 100 men. That's you, Lil Leo. My specialty. Here, and how old are you?
20.
Whoo! My specialty is making women blank. Go on, say it out loud.
Cook.
Here I give you an opportunity to make a statement about your male prowess, a chance to put it out there for all ears to hear, some specialty you might have in making women do what? Your big ass say cook. Cook. All right, we got two strikes, Philip. Come on now. Whitney family can still fill in the blank. We ask 100 men, my specialty is making women what?
With my experience, I make them feel special.
Yeah. That's nice. I like that. That's a grown man answer right there. You know, what do you mean by that? What is it that you doing that's so damn special? Now we finna get into what this answer really is. Philip, we ask 100 men, my special is making women blank. I make them feel special. What you talking about, Philip?
I make them fall in love with me, Steve.
Now, Leo, now what did we just learn here? Make them fall in love.
I got a lot of time left.
he said, Steve, I'm just 20. Matter of fact, I don't even want nobody in love with me right now. I ain't mad at you, Leo. Fall in love. Fill in the blank. Yes, 100 million. My specialty is making women what?
Mad.
Good answer! Yeah.
Mad! Yeah. Number six. Five.
Cringe.
Disgusting.
Man, what 100 men? Four.
Cry.
Number two.